my channel. So today I really wanted to film here because it's snowing. Can you see? It's snowing outside. And then it got really sunny and I couldn't film, but the sun's actually gone behind a cloud. So if I get this done quick, I'll be able to stay here and I won't need to set up again. So today, as you can tell, here comes that sun. It's never sunny in England, so why is it sunny today? I can't see anything. Okay, take two. Ah! It literally has taken me over half an hour to find this spot, and now I've just moved the camera. I'm just gonna run with it. What the hell? I can't see anything, so let's just go because whatever. Okay, I don't even know where I started. I've completely messed this one up, but I'm just gonna roll with it. So I don't even know if I've said this, but if I have, I'm gonna say it again. So thank you for all the support over Christmas. I really noticed a big increase in all of my viewing, my interaction. I really enjoyed it, which is the most important thing because it takes so much time. If you don't enjoy it, then what's the point? So I'm back. I had like a week off, which was not a week off, just like I didn't film, but I've planned so much content. I've got a really exciting emotional video plan, something I really want to speak about. It's got nothing to do with fashion, so really excited to share that with you. Completely opposite to this self-obsessed, self-indulgent, first world problem Hermes story. So it's just me, really. I like fashion, I like nice bags, but there's also another side of me, so I'm going to be showing that as well. So back to what this is actually about before I sit here for 25 minutes talking. If you follow me on Snapchat, you will know for at least a year, I have wanted an Hermes Kelly. Not just any Hermes, it has to be a Kelly, it has to be a particular size, color, yada yada, and it has been impossible for me to find. Impossible. Yes, I could buy from a reseller. I mean, I can find the exact bag I want on Instagram 10 times over, but I refuse to buy from this kind of place. And the reason is, I'm going to go into this on another video, but please don't just find somebody on Instagram that's reselling bags. Sorry, I had to start again because So, where was I? Don't just buy a bag from Instagram. Yes, some of these are related to a registered company. I have a friend that rebuys and sells Hermes. There are really good online sites that I can suggest in the description box below. These are all fine, but don't just randomly find someone on Instagram because this is just a car crash waiting to happen. You can't be doing this randomly anyway, but something as expensive as an Hermes bag for me is not an option and I don't advise doing that. But right now I'm still on the hunt to get it from the store. I've said about 55 times I'm going to give up, but I'm not really the kind of person that gives up on anything, so I'm still going a year and a half later on. I have tried in Paris, in every boutique in London, like literally 500 times in London, Saint-Tropez, New York, Dubai, every airport, like the list goes on. I have really, really tried to get this bag. And if you follow me on Snapchat, as I was saying earlier, you will know that I snap like, let's go into Hermes again, let them laugh when I ask them about Achille. And it's been kind of an ongoing joke, and I'm so passionate about getting this, and I'm sure there's so many people that can, one, relate to trying to get an Hermes, and two, maybe you just find it so entertaining and pathetic you just want to listen to my story anyway, and I respect that. But I just want to share my story really because I haven't personally seen a video about this kind of thing. So when I do get mine, because I will get mine, this will be like the build up to the story. So from the beginning, I have always wanted a Chanel bag, and the day that I got it, it was like the best day ever, still was one of the best days ever, and it was like the highest level that I would ever go. I knew about Hermes bags. I used to work in Harrods. Like, all my clients had them. they were no. I liked them, but I wasn't going to prepare. I wasn't prepared to spend that kind of money. And I remember my friend Vic from uni. She said to me, "Oh, Claire, this girl I know has got a Birkin. Yeah, you so need one of these." And the exact words were, "I would never spend £5,000 on a handbag. They're not even £5,000 anymore. They're literally." I think that Birkin that we were talking about is like 7,000 now. So we fast forward like 7 years time, I think. No, actually less than that. I am now getting one. So the reason is because I do have quite a lot of bags, which I've collected over the years. And the way I see it is my opinion, I would prefer to sell 3 of them and get the bag that I really want. So I have done that. I've taken money from things that I have sold. I like to recycle, sell to buy and all this jazz. So I've done that, and then it doesn't seem as bad. And you can try that with any technique. You can sell 3 pairs of high street shoes to get a designer pair of shoes. It works in whatever way you want. So that is how I'm funding mine. I am buying it all myself. I've saved up the money, and the only problem is I can't get one. So the story of getting an Hermes. I think I am pretty confident and pretty experienced when it comes to luxury shopping. The reason is I shop a lot for myself. I shop a lot for clients when I'm styling, like really high-end stuff I can't even afford for myself. So I'm really experienced that side. More importantly, I sold at Harrods for 5 years, so I am that person that is selling. So I get it. I completely understand how it all goes. So to me, I'm not intimidated going into a store, like a high-end store, which I understand why a lot of you are, because I would if I wasn't in the industry. So I keep saying so, I've got to stop saying so. I think it's because in French we say alors, and I'm doing the same. So, right. When I first went to get my bag, I heard all the rumours. As I said, one of my really good friends buys and sells Hermes. Her name's Sabrina. She's an Hermes authenticator. She knows everything about Hermes. So I'm so happy I have her in my life to help me with this journey. So, I'm really sorry. I'm not going to say anymore. She told me about all the rules about how you've got to dress up. Well, loads of people told me you've got to dress up when you go there. You've got to wear something Hermes. How can I wear something Hermes when you won't give me anything in the first place? And I can't afford to keep going in there buying cuffs and bracelets and whatever. I can't. Like, all my money is going on this. It's bloody ridiculous. So, honestly, if I do that again, then you might even notice, but it's really bugging me that I keep saying that word. Now all I want to do is say that word. It's really hard. So she said to me that you have to go in there and buy some things first, build up a relationship. And I think this is all completely ridiculous. As I was saying, it's ridiculous. My mind's gone now. And I just think that I hate it when people go, I don't want to have to dress up to go somewhere. We were trained in Harrods to like look for the people that have money and are going to shop. And it's normally the people that aren't dressed up, and it's normally local people. And it doesn't matter. If you dress up, it doesn't mean you have money. Like, I'm going to go shopping today to Hermes in a £15 polyester jumper. They're not going to know. How do they know how much my jumper is? I've got Tom Ford jeans on. They don't know they're Tom Ford jeans. It's ridiculous. I can't stand this kind of thing. So I ignored this. And if I was in the gym and I went to Hermes, I'd go, big mistake, because they literally ignore you. Whereas other high-end stores, like Harrods and places like that, they don't do that. So I really hate that about Hermes. I really hate that you feel judged when you go in there. And I could go in there with all my designer stuff, but it makes me cringe, to be honest. And yes, I have some CDC cuffs. I could wear both on one wrist if I wanted to, but I refuse to be like that. And this is what is stopping me from getting a bag. I just know it. And you almost have to go in there and just speak to the... Oh, it's just been a nightmare. And I'm so stubborn and against this way of life. This is what I think stopped me. So I used Plan B and I just shoved Paris in there one day because they love him. True story, I went in to try and get a bag, made him do all the talking. He was speaking in French, they seemed to love it if you speak French. And they were like, yes, yes, when their bag comes in, we will get it for you, no problem, give me 2 weeks. I go in there 2 weeks later without him, they're like, no, I never said that to you. I'm sure they don't like me, but whatever. Another thing that I was told to do was, what was the other thing? So dress up, buy Hermes before you're allowed in Hermes. Oh, are you local? I heard, I heard if you are local to an Hermes store, which I am local to two, apparently that helps. And I do believe this because when I was giving my information, the first thing they asked me is, are you local to this store? Well, that didn't mean anything, still didn't get one. I almost found one in Newport in California. I was so happy, but they literally teased me and said I couldn't have it because it's for locals and they don't sell to tourists. But yeah, in London they sell to tourists. So it's all very frustrating and I'm kind of glad I didn't get it there because it would have been more expensive. And since the day I started my search, it has gone up around £5,000. So I am this close to giving up, but I just feel like I can't. So today, the whole point of this video, I am going to go to all the stores in London and I am going to just show you how frustrating it is. You never know, I might even come out with a bag. Who knows? I'm really sorry about the light as well because the light is about to go any second. You have literally till 4 p.m. in England to have light. So I know that by the time I get to London, because I'm in Essex at the moment, it's going to be dark. So whatever, I'm just going to use the word so. Because I'm from Essex and we say so a lot. And yeah, it's going to be completely dark, so I'm really sorry about that. If it's that bad, then I'll stay in London and I'll do it again tomorrow. But I think that's it. Oh, one thing, I mean, I can't film when I go in there because they honestly are not going to give me anything if I do that, is I'm not joking. You walk in the store, it doesn't matter what store, and you wait there patiently. I've waited there for half an hour before. And you say, hi, I'm looking for... I'm always embarrassed to say it. Hi, I'm looking for Kelly. Every single time they laugh. Why are you laughing? If I go to Tesco's and say, do you have any milk? They're not going to be like, do you know how many people want milk? If we can't get milk, where am I meant to buy the milk then? It's literally like that. Where else am I meant to buy an Hermes bag? Don't laugh at me. And the last time I was like, why is it funny? That's probably why I didn't get a bag from that place. Because I said, why is it funny? Can I just ask you why you think it's funny? Because I am coming in here every day. Every day for 3 months I did it in last summer to the stores in London. And I just said, why is it funny? Like, why is it funny that when I ask to buy a bag, it's funny to you? So, I mean, I'm just basically explaining why no one at Hermes likes me, aren't I? It's obvious now I'm saying it out loud. So I'm still going to try. And in the meantime, I did start a couple of months ago searching for a reseller or somewhere to buy pre-loved. And I really didn't want to buy pre-loved. And if I do, it has got to be pristine, with the box, with the receipt, with an authenticator that I know of. If I don't know the authenticator, I'm not doing it. I met an authenticator once that told me that this Kelly was real, and even I knew it wasn't real. So yeah, Sabrina's going to help me, and I am going to start considering pre-loved now because this whole Hermes buy-in has really kind of ruined it for me to the point where I just don't want it. But then I see someone with it and I'm like, I want it. So let's see, really. So let's go to all the stores in London, see how many people laugh in my face. You never know. This might be the day that I get one. I'm telling you now, it's not going to be. I'm just going to come away from it feeling frustrated. And I just wanted to share it with you, really. And then I think I'm going to concentrate more on trying to find one elsewhere. Because I spoke to somebody on Instagram, like one of this friend I've made on Instagram. So funny. My Instagram friend. And she has two beautiful Kellys. And we were chatting and we seemed like quite similar. And she said that, I'm going to put her in the description box below. And she said that she sold all of her bags to fund this one Kelly. And then she loved it so much, she sold even more bags, like the rest of her bags. And now she has a brown one. And they were both pre-loved. And I never would have thought because they were pristine, in the box, everything. So she has kind of encouraged me that it's okay to buy pre-loved. So I'm going to do that. I'm going to start looking. I have already been looking for 2-3 months and I still haven't got anywhere. So when I do get it... Bambina! What's the matter, Bambina? Come here then. This dog is so naughty. Okay, that's it. So I'm going to take with me to all the Hermes stores. It's already going dark, but let's see how I get on. And I hope you enjoy my Hermes search. Can we just talk about my eyebrows? I was going to do an eyebrow video today. And the reason why, that's my letterbox going because it's so windy. a lot of you have been asking for an eyebrow tutorial. This is like major for me because I am the girl. I am the girl that couldn't do eyebrows. Honestly, I couldn't do them. When I look back at my pictures and my video, I'm like, you didn't even used to do your eyebrows, and when you did, it was horrific. So this is literally unbelievable that I'm getting the brows. If you've been watching this video and you don't like them, it's because I'm experimenting with different products, because when I do my brow video, I want to do like 3 or 4 techniques with different brow products, different like bushy, soapy, boxy, whatever, natural. So I'm just experimenting, and this is the first time I've experimented with this product and did it this way. So if you don't like them, that's why. But, and the only reason why I didn't do the brow video as well is because I feel like my skin's really bad, and for like a close-up video I was a bit conscious. I'll be doing that next week. Let's go to Hermes. Paris?
Yes?
You want to come to Hermes with me?
To get to Hermes?
Yeah.
Okay.
Well, I kind of need you because you need to speak French.
Okay.
You want to come?
Where?
We're going to every single Hermes store in London. He gets nervous. Are you nervous? He's done it again. You've done it again. He's copied my outfit.
Matching outfit.
And you've got the exact same. Mm-hmm. You've got the exact. Have you done it on purpose? You copied my outfit.
I didn't. You copied me. I was wasn't dressed.
You had a whole All Saints outfit on.
In front of me, did you?
So you come into
Am I looking at the screen or that?
That, but this is my bad side. This is my good side. So you come into Hermes with me?
Yeah.
Are you going to speak French to them and get me one?
Mm-hmm.
When we go in there and we ask for a Kelly, what do they say? When I say hi, I've got a Kelly, what do they say?
They first start speaking to me, and then when they see
Yeah, they ignore me, dismiss me.
And then they say, come back next week.
And then we come back next week, and what happens?
They say, come back next week.
And this has happened for a year, hasn't it?
Apparently, MS hasn't produced any back.
Yeah.
Okay, I wanna go.
Okay, we're going. Bye. On our way to London, I have the babies. I changed my outfit because I wasn't feeling the other outfit. The grey one didn't seem to be. I think it is the same as the grey one. Looking at my outfit. Yeah, Paris has got the exact same outfit as me on, so that's not a good start, is it, for our Hermes shopping trip. I must say that we look the scruffiest we've looked in a long, long time. Do you agree? So yeah, I have a feeling that today's not gonna go great, but I've got my acne aviator here, so that should hide the mess that's underneath. And I got this mirror delivered at home, which is going to the flat, so I'm gonna take that out. And here we go to London.
I need to be swept away, swept away. I'm cornered in the cold where you left me. Left again, left again. Oh, there's a jungle in my head growing wilder. And it's killing me, killing me. I cannot let you go, I cannot let you go. I cannot let you go, I cannot let you go.
Street, about to go to the Hermes store, and it looks like, I didn't know, but they're building an Hermes store. This is next to the Jumeirah Hotel. Is it the Jumeirah Hotel? Paris?
I think so, yeah.
Okay, so that one's not open. Maybe we can try that when it opens, but for now we'll just go to the other one. Well, I hope it's still open. Oh, hey, Chanel. I wish I filmed that. Obviously I can't film in Hermes, so I go in there. I was waiting for around 10 minutes, which is quite good. And I said, oh, is blah, blah, blah there, the lady that we're dealing with? And they said, oh, yeah, she knows your husband. Great, so we couldn't go in together because basically, remember a few weeks ago, I filmed me going to try and get a parking permit.
They wanted blood from me, wouldn't give me one, and I only got a couple of months for my parking permit, so we don't actually have one. So we're literally tag team by the car. So I'm not going to get anywhere, so I've sent him in, and he's going to deal with her, because they all speak French in there. So, oh God, that windswept makes me look like a boy. So yeah, he's gone in, and I'm just going to wait here on the traffic warden watch, and we'll see what he says. You never know, he might come out with a big orange bag. Not. You see him? He's right there. Go Paris, go. Go Paris, go. Go Paris, go. We're only at the first round, and I literally want to give up already. It's raining. Oh look, there's Dior. I'm actually going to go into Dior. I'm absolutely freezing. So they've made him wait for like 20 minutes now, which is so typical. Like, can you see what I mean about how awful this is? It's like my whole day that I've put aside for this, and it completely ruins the experience. That, and they're not nasty in there. Like, I was going to call them bouncers. The guys on the door are like, being really nice and like joking with us, so everyone's nice in there. It's just this whole like, what hair am I? It's just this whole like, you can't sit with us vibe, and I just really don't like that. So they're squashing my dreams. So 20 minutes later, I've had to come in the car because it's raining, and this is what happens. I give up and I'm like, oh yeah, Dior's there, oh she looks so good. Going to Hermes is the best people watching, like the chicest girls. Well, not everyone's chic, but that girl looked really good. I end up thinking, like, being next to Dior or Chanel and end up spending my money there, and I've done that twice before over the last year, saved up the money and then end up buying a couple of other bags, and I'm not doing it this time. I'm not doing it. So he's still there. I might give up, but I've got Harrods to go, Bond Street to go, Selfridges to go, three more to go. Doesn't look great.
It'll be really fun. Nope. If somebody walks out of that shop with a big Hermes bag and they're asking what's inside, then she says, oh, it's okay.
Where's it going? Oh, I thought he was telling me to get out of the car and he had good news. What happened? Good?
Yeah, she's got a black Birkin, if you want.
Liar.
No, I'm not even joking.
You're joking. Okay, so I was expecting him to say no, and then he said yes, and I got in a panic and I cut him off while speaking, but there you have something quite promising. This is the most exciting thing that's ever happened in Hermes, so maybe this camera thing and vlogging thing is bringing me luck, but
panicking.
I know, I'm panicking. But this has never happened, has it?
Well, I've never been on my own.
That's exactly right. You've never been on your own. And look what happens when you did. Well, I'm clearly... Well, I've always said I'm tacky, he's chic. So, right, we found it. Send someone chic that speaks French. The biggest tip I can give you, because this is the best thing that's ever happened. Why has he got a big Hermes orange bag?
No, he was looking at a weird one.
Yeah, that's normally the case. So, I need to think about this because she likes Paris. I mean, who doesn't like you? Everyone likes you, don't they?
Yeah, no one likes you. No one likes
you. I'm in such a panic, I can't even think. So... If she'd have just offered this and that was it, I might have taken it, but it's not exactly what I want. To be honest, it's not a Kelly, but it's the next best thing. But she did say, you've been coming for so long. I think we've really proved ourselves now. I think, well, you've proved yourself, that I think that it's worth holding out. But this looks good, doesn't it?
Mm-hmm. Wow.
Should we not bother going to the other ones? You're gonna say no, you don't wanna. Okay, let's just go to Harrods and see what they say. Just come out of tarots that did not go well. That went pretty much how it goes every single time I go in there. It was completely packed and I didn't recognize one sales assistant, which is not good, because if you don't deal with the same sales assistant every time, you're guaranteed not to get one, because you need to keep going back over and over again to show them that you're serious. It's pathetic, really. So I didn't recognise anyone, but I waited. After 35 minutes, I gave up because... Please stop biting your nails. After 35 minutes, I gave up. That was a waste of 35 minutes, basically. No one even said hello or smiled or acknowledged me to say, we'll be with you. Sorry, it's busy. Someone will be with you. You literally stand there like a drip. Like, wasting time. So that didn't go well. Still raining, and oh, there's the there you go. There's the new Hermes store. That looks like it's gonna be a really good one. So going by that service, the Sloane Street service was actually quite good today. Oh, and also with Harrods, I do want to buy it in Harrods because I have a rewards card, and their rewards card system is, honestly, please stop biting your nails. I really don't like it. The rewards card system at Harrods is really, really good, so you get cash back when you buy, kind of like a Boots card. I am a black card holder, and it doesn't seem to make any difference, and I'm not going to stand there and be like, oh, black card holder, can you please serve me, or can I have a bag if I'm a black card holder? That's really cringe, so I didn't mention it, but the point is that I'm making, if you are a black card holder at Harrods, it doesn't make any difference, because they don't even ask, so... Just letting you know that. So now we're gonna go to Bond Street and see how that is. But I think I have my relationship best. Paris has his relationship with Sloane Street. So this looks like we've put the most effort in there. So this one looks like it's gonna be the best. So let's go to Bond Street. And then we've got two more to go. You're loving today, aren't you? Well, I'm going to take in Nando's and buy him some like wine or beer to keep you happy. Yeah, does that sound good? Bond Street store, the Hermes Bond Street store, and I thought, oh, I'll take a quick picture to get my thumbnail for this vlog, and two lovely girls came over and said hi, and it was really funny because Paris was moaning in the street, like, I'm hungry, I don't feel well, I'm cold, can you hurry up? And he was filming, and they come over and said hello, and me and Paris stopped filming. So did you get it or not?
Hello.
Well, I guess if you've seen it, then he got it. But that was so nice. It's literally so nice. So I was checking her out, actually, because I was just staring at the door for a photo. And I was like, oh, she looks nice. And oh, she's just bought something. What she bought? Oh, she's got a nice Chanel bag. I was just completely checking her out. And then she was like, are you Claire? And I'm like, yeah. So it's really nice when that happens, because sometimes someone will see me and then tweet me afterwards. And I think, oh, why didn't they say hello? Because... it makes me realise that people are actually watching what I'm doing, and it's just such a nice feeling, and nice to... I've actually met some of you that Snapchat me, so it's nice to put like a proper face and meet you when... Do you get what I'm saying? So it was just really nice. Anyway, I was pleasantly surprised. It was not busy in there at all. And someone came over to me, two people come over to me. So it's been going really well, actually. And I told her the one that I wanted, and she said, we don't have that today, but keep trying. I've got a good deal. Like, she was really, really nice. And she said, keep trying, give it a couple of months and you'll probably get one. So that was quite promising. And I was quite pleased with how that went. So far, so good. And it looks like it stopped raining as well now. One more to go and then we'll get something to eat, yeah? He's yawning again.
So boring.
I mean, it is a bit boring, but it just has to be done. And I just want to show you how boring this process is. One more to go. Oh, out of the Selfridges, the Hermes and Selfridges, I wasn't going to bother with that because one, I got a really good vibe from the Sloane Street and it was raining, and Selfridges is so far away from Chelsea. I just thought I just didn't have a good vibe. So I go in there and I meet the nicest boy, or ma'am, he's a boy to me, nice Greek boy. He was so nice. He's actually told me about a really amazing perfume. It's the rose and leather one, which I'm definitely going to buy that when I get my bag. But it's really, really nice. It's rose and leather. So anyway, I was talking to him. He was so nice. I got really good service from the Hermes and Selfridges, which I really thought was going to be the worst one. So that's probably been my favourite place so far. And have a good feeling about the Selfridges one. So overall, today has gone really, really well. And oh, I was sniffing on the ribbon, the perfume like this, and some girl came over and said hello, which again was just so nice. It makes me jump when it happens because I'm just not expecting it. So she came over and said hello and said she loves my videos, and it makes my day. And I think the Hermes man was a bit like, who is this girl? But it literally made my day. So I didn't ask the girl her name, but thank you for saying hello. It was really, really lovely. What's the time?
2:30.
2 o'clock. So we started at
2:30.
Oh, 2:30. So we started at 10 a.m. It's now 2:30. That's how long it's taken me. And I guess watch this space, really. This isn't the start of the journey. This is a year and a half into the journey. So watch this space. What I have learned for sure is that you should invest in one sales associate, one store, definitely not in different countries because that will get you nowhere, and just keep going and showing how passionate you are and serious you are. I know it's a long process, but that is definitely the number one thing that I've learned. And don't really worry about the dressing up. That's cringy. I think anyone could pretend to have money, so just be yourself and go yourself. But I'm not going to give you too much advice because at the end of the day, I don't have one, so I haven't really nailed the whole Hermes shopping process. So once I do, I will tell you exactly how I got it and the best advice that I can give you. But for now, we just have to watch this space. I hope that this was interesting. I just really wanted to share the whole process of how hard it is to get the bag. And just something I wanted to share with you. And I know that I've got to stop going like this with my double chin. And I know that Paris is really bored, but thank you for coming with me.
Oh, yeah.
So I've let him choose a restaurant of his choice, and then we'll go to the pub because that's something that he enjoys. I don't, but you got to have a balance, haven't you, to make each other happy. So we're going to do that. And that's the end of my Hermes. No, not the end of the Hermes mission. That's the end of today. So stay tuned and we will get there. Thanks for watching.